But at least today, I get to do the one thing that makes it all worthwhile, and that's getting one of our dogs into a new home. A local girl named Katie is coming to see if she can find a companion for her pit bull.
Hi.
How are you?
Katie?
Yeah.
Hi.
My name is Katie. I'm from New Orleans, and I came to Villalobos today to adopt my second pit bull to go along with my first female pit bull.
What's her name?
This is Bootyfoots.
Oh boy, that's a mouthful.
Yes.
Before I got Bootyfoots, I really didn't know where she had come from. She was in very bad shape. She had a broken leg. She was very malnourished. She was scared of everyone. The first 3 days I had her, she didn't open her eyes. Part of the healing process was my first roommate who had another dog. It was like her best friend. Okay. And he just moved away, sadly. And that's part of the reason why I chose now to get another dog is because he really was like her best friend.
I'm assuming that means that she likes other dogs.
Yes and no, but she's not a dog that is instantly like, you're great, I love you. Bootyfoots has a tendency to be dog aggressive. Sometimes she's good, sometimes she's not good. So I'm hoping to find a good match for her today. She takes a little bit to warm up because she's very apprehensive of a lot of things. Okay. So.
Katie explained to me her temperament. You know, she can be a little rough around the edges on the approach when it comes to meeting other dogs. So, you know, we have to find the right dog. It's just like matchmaking. Okay, so let me get all my stuff and we'll go outside and we'll go into the bridge.
You want to meet some friends? You want a new brother? You want a new brother?
Yeah. This adoption is all about Bootyfoots finding a dog that makes the right connection with her. In the pit bull world, at least, you know, female dogs do tend to get along better with other male dogs as opposed to another female dog. So it's finding the right mix, it's finding the right personality, it's finding the right age, the right temperament, the right size. All these things factor into partnering up dogs together.
Okay, so I'll take her. She's never gotten in a fight. She likes her personal space. She will warn dogs, like, you know.
I don't blame her for that.
When Earl comes out with the dog, we'll just have you go off to the side. I asked Earl to help me with this adoption. He's been on kennel duty ever since I hired him. He's a really hard worker, and he's so good with the dogs. So he's definitely earned his right to pitch in and help us with an adoption.
Oh, boy. This is my first meet and greet. I think she sees my dedication not only to her and the Villalobos rescue, but to the dogs also. And I think she sees that.
So I asked Earl to bring out Cole first. Cole was brought to us by a Good Samaritan who found him on the street here in New Orleans. And it's pretty apparent that he was the victim of a dogfight. His face was literally ripped off. There was nothing left. They had to do plastic surgery and get pieces of flesh and muscle and put it back together. It's just a horrible, horrible treatment of this dog. And despite that, he just turned out to be the kindest, most forgiving dog you'll ever meet. But as nice as he is, there's still no guarantee that these two will get along.
This is Cole, handsome Cole. He is beautiful. Come on, mommy.
So right off the bat, Bootyfoot seemed a little nervous around Cole.
That one may be a little too much.
Cole is bigger than Bootyfoot's, and I think he was a little overwhelming when he jumped on her. He's just a big dog, and I think she needs a dog that's a little bit more pulled back.
You did good. You did good.
Cole is great with other dogs, but you know, that was a bit much. So at that point, I kind of decided that I don't want to take that chance with those two dogs.
So we'll take him back, and then we'll get out the puppy, Rock.
Rock?
Yeah. Come on, Rock. Come on.
Seeing how Bootyfoots was intimidated by Cole and maybe his size, I decided to switch directions and bring out a smaller, less intimidating dog.
Who's that little guy?
Rock is one of the dogs that we caught under the house on St. Rock.
Hi, little puppies.
He was very, very skittish at first.
You poor little things. Oh, they're so afraid.
But his confidence has built up quite a bit. We figured, you know, he's a small puppy, and we thought maybe that wouldn't be as threatening to Bootyfoots, and maybe that she would accept him quicker.
Oh, he's so tiny.
Come on, mommy.
Bootyfoots, be nice to him. Be gentle.
Easy, easy. Come on, mommy. It's okay. Who's that little guy?
You know, Bootyfoot's body language was completely different. She was completely open to play and a lot more at ease.
This is somebody I can push around.
I know, right?
You know, Bootyfoot's and Rock, went pretty well. What do you think?
Rock. Hey, Rock. Hey, Rock.
It's a different thing, and I am a little apprehensive about a puppy because, you know, you don't know their temperament as well.
So Katie, you know, for reasons of her own, didn't really want a puppy. She wanted a dog that was a little more mature, just something that she kind of already knew how it was going to turn out. So I thought of the perfect kind of in-between option.
Come on, Grizzly.
Grizzly is one of the 20 Ninth Ward puppies that we took in, like, our first week in New Orleans. Grizzly got his name based on his looks and his temperament, you know, Grizzly Bear. Add to that his personality. Out of all the puppies, he was the only one that just kind of had, like, this dopey, laid-back, real slow personality and behavior, just like bears. But his low-key temperament and personality might have actually worked against him in the past, because he has been passed up twice for an adoption. So now that he's out of that cute little puppy phase and kind of in his teenage months, you know, it can be harder for these dogs to find homes. But hopefully he'll be a good fit for Bootyfoots.
Oh my goodness, he's cute.
We don't want them to meet Earl, we just want them to walk.
Good boy.
Don't let them get near each other. Yikes.
At first, Bootyfoots was pretty hyper, which is not unusual, but I was kind of like, oh, Lord, you know, she's going crazy. She's going to drive the other dogs away.
Come on, Grizzly.
You behave. So Bootyfoots kept pulling towards Grizzly, and it got to the point where I had to think, you know, is she trying to play with this dog, or is she going to become aggressive with him? And our once mellow little puppy was getting it all fired up, too.
Easy. Just kind of stay there, Earl. I'm just going to kind of let her calm down. Come here. Come here. Nope.
Normally, I walk them, but the walking is stimulating her too much, so I just decided to try something different and just let her relax.
You know, because we take pride in really knowing our dogs and their personalities and temperament, I knew in my heart of heart that Grizzly would be a good match for Bootyfoots.
It's okay. You're doing okay. Okay. Good girl. Good girl. Good boy, Grizz.
Just going by Bootyfoot's and Grizzly's body language, I could tell that this was going to be a good match.
Nice kisses. Good girl.
Good girl.
When the two dogs finally met, Bootyfoot definitely seemed happy and interested.
Good boy, Grizz.
Well, that was a nice little greet.
Yeah.
So at that point, you know, it's because the dogs did well, it's up to Katie to figure out what she wants to do.
Grizzly actually looks exactly like my roommate's old dogs.
Oh.
Yeah.
So,
Grizzly?
Grizzly, yeah. After seeing Grizzly interact with Bootyfoots, he just seems like the best fit out of all three of them. Thanks, Tia.
Bye, thanks
so much for your help.
Bye, Bootyfoots. I know how to say your name now.
Say bye.
Now that we've narrowed it down to Grizzly, the next thing we want to do is work on some training. In Grizzly's case, it's socialization skills. You know, these puppies grew up in our kennel, and he hasn't been out and about in the real world. So I decided that's what we were gonna do, was to take him out into the city of New Orleans and start to prepare him for his new home.